Hello everyone, this is Hoda Genji. In the last video, we talked about how to add rebars to a concrete shear wall. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can add rebars to the foundation here. So, how about I draw two sections from this isolated foundation? I'm going to go to my foundation level. Actually, we have a couple of sections here. I want to move this one over here. I want to go to this section. And I would like to have a callout from here. So how about I go to my view, let's go with callout, rectangle, draw one here, and I can move this maybe over there. Let's go to the callout, and this is good. So this is one of the sections that I need. Make sure to put this on fine, so the steel elements are gonna have the thickness. And I want to go to my level. We have another view here, and I want to make a call out from this one. It's going to be around here. So let's go to view, call out here. I can select this, move this to this side, and this is my second call out, and I would like to change this to fine. Now, how about I keep the three views here, the two callouts and maybe the 3D. I'm gonna go with WT so you can see the views side by side, and we're gonna add some rebars to this foundation. Now, as you remember, the rebar is under structure. Notice that I'm working on an architectural template, but we do have all these reinforcement ideas here. Next, I would like to assign a cover. You remember it's easier to assign cover and then assign the rebar, because then the rebar is going to be fit in the cover. So how about I go with cover? To that shear wall, we assigned 40 millimeters of cover, assuming that it's going to create some fire rating for us. To the foundation, I want to go with 25 millimeters. So select the element, and I want to go with 25 millimeter on all sides. So I want to go with peak element. I don't need to go with peak faces. If you have different amount of covers on different faces, that's when you need to switch to peak faces. So this is now good. You see 25 is assigned. Now let me show you something interesting. If you go to the 3D view and go to rebar, you're gonna have these options, right? Like align surface and so on. This is how we created the rebars for the shear wall. But if I go to section view and go to rebar, you see the rebar items are different. They're based on the work plane. So this is what I want to do. I want to go to my section view, go to rebar, and I want to click on this little thing. It's very useful. It's going to actually show me all the rebar shapes. So you see all of these are now visible. So, if you don't have the shapes, that means you have not loaded the shapes, the rebar shapes. In that case, you can go to load shapes. You remember it's under structural rebar shapes. You remember I hit Ctrl A in the last video and imported all of them at once. Now, here. First, I want to create a set of rebars on this direction. So, for instance, if I go here, go to rebar, and select the profile that I want to go, and I want to go with this simple profile here. You see, now that it's actually on current work plane, and then it's set to parallel to work plane, it's going to create these longitudinal rebars. If I want to create it on the other section, I need to switch to perpendicular to cover. So I want to go to this view, go to rebar, and I want to use perpendicular to cover. We have this shape here, the U shape. If you scroll down, there is also another U shape, which is going to give you actually more edge on here. So if you want to involve this further on this side of on the depths of the foundation, you can go with this one, and it's set to perpendicular to cover, and I want to click somewhere around here once. Okay, so now if you go to 3D and change this to wireframe, you can see the rebar. You remember, if you want to show the thickness, you need to click on it, go to Edit under Properties and check the box for View as Solid. So, and now it's only one. If I want to have multiple, you can either go with every few inches or millimeters by assigning maximum spacing, or if you already know the number, you can go with fixed number and you can assign like 10 around here. And you see it on this view as well. Next, I want to have some rebars on the other side. So how about I go to the same section callout, and I want to go to structure, rebar. I want to use the same shape. The only difference is that this time it's going to be parallel to work plane. So I want to click here and I want to hover the mouse around here. Notice that if you hover the mouse at the top, it's going to be at the top. If you hover the mouse at the bottom, this is the correct direction. So I want to click here. Once the rebar is created, I can make it a solid rebar by going to edit, check the box. And now we need some adjustments here. I want to first change it to maximum spacing or fixed number. Maybe we have 6 of them on this side. Those are something that you need to ask your structural engineer about it, about the size of the rebar as well as the number of them. And now I want to make sure there are no conflicts. So I want to move this one a little bit inside, so it's not gonna conflict with the other rebars, a little bit inside here and a little bit inside here. Or you can use edit constraints after you create it. So this seems good. We have rebars on both sides of this section. I want to switch to tab view, so I want to hit TW. And last thing I want to do is to go to the foundation level. I can change this to fine wireframe for a second. And if you have the same shape for your other foundations, you can actually copy and paste the rebars or array them into other locations. So I can go with copy, constrain, and multiple maybe, and you can copy this here and in the other views.